her business practices are a forerunner of Islamic finance as we try and practice it today?
Well, she used to, as she didn't travel herself far away, so she used to send within the Quraysh tribe. They had Quraysh had a huge caravan which used to go in the summer season to the Levant, which we call today, which used to be called in Arabic Bilad al-Sham, which is Syria, Lebanon, Palestine, Jordan today. And which was called in the Orientalist literature the Levant. So in the summer, because it is hot, so people go towards the north. So the caravan, the summer caravan, used to go towards the north. And Quraysh, as a tribe of Mecca, they used to contribute to finance this trade. And they used to use a contract, which is the Mubaraba contract, which we use today. And that is an investment management contract. Somebody has wealth and somebody has expertise. So the capital, or the capitalists, if you want to say, they will contribute their capital, and the traders and entrepreneurs will contribute their trade, and so on. So they would prepare a caravan in the winter, in the summer, to send it to the Levant, and in the winter to send it to Yemen, to the south, and where there is, of course, it is the incense route and the so famous, they call it the Harir, Tariq al-Harir, the Silk Road, and so on and so forth. So they used to all pass through this area, and she used to contribute and to give contribution. And one of the traders that she gave money to contribute to was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She sent a large amount of cash with him in order to trade. Now what they used to do is buy this cash, they buy goods from the Arabian area, from Mecca, they take it to the Levant, sell it there, and then buy goods which are prominent there and bring them to Mecca and trade in them. So the Prophet ﷺ was very successful in this Mudaraba contract, which we use today. This Mudaraba, when Islam came, the Mudaraba contract was known. However, in Islam, there were introduced certain conditions and stipulations that will prevent this contract to become effectively an interest-bearing loan.